For our second example, once again, this is a polynomial with integer coefficients, which means they're also rational coefficients, so I can also write that. And I'm trying to verify whether this is reducible or irreducible over the rationals. Once again, it's the same question as the previous one. Irreducible over the rationals or not. Can't apply Eisenstein's criterion directly, but we can always try this mod p irreducibility test. And it is an irreducibility test, not a reducibility test. So what you're usually hoping is you're hoping that it's irreducible so that you can actually apply this theorem. Not that irreducibility is quote unquote better than reducibility, but just in terms of answering the question, this is what you're hoping you can apply. So we've got in this test a polynomial with integer coefficients, which once again can be thought of as rational coefficients, but we want them to keep this simple to have integer coefficients. You create a new polynomial called f bar of x in zpx based on the original polynomial by modding all its coefficients by p, or p is some prime, reducing all the coefficients of f of x modulo p. If it turns out that this f bar of x is irreducible over zp, and if the degree is the same as the original degree, then this test says f of x, the original polynomial, is irreducible over q. So you're hoping you can apply this, typically with p equal to 2 or 3 perhaps, and so let's hope that 2 works, and it does end up working. Create f bar of x by reducing all the coefficients by 2. Hey, they're all ones and zeros. It's the exact same polynomial. That doesn't always happen, but I'm thinking of it not as being in zx, but z2x. Sometimes you do actually have to do something with the coefficients. Like if this was a 2x there, or this, if this was a 5x there in z, originally in this polynomial ring, and you were modding by 2, you'd have to convert the 5 to a 1. If you were modding by 3, you'd have to convert the 5 to a 2. So now the question is, so the degree stayed the same. Note, the degree of this new polynomial f bar of x is the same as the original degree. We need that to happen if we're going to have any hope of success in applying this mod p irreducibility test. You don't want to reduce it so that the coefficient of the highest degree term goes away. So then the question is this irreducible over z2 or not? You're hoping that it is. It's easy to show it's got no linear factors because it's got no zeros in z2. There's only two numbers to check, 0 and 1. 0 is not a root. And 1 is also not a root. We're doing mod 2 arithmetic here. So it's got no linear factors. Neither 0 nor 1, which are the only possible zeros in z2, is a 0 of f bar of x. So x minus 0 and x minus 1 can't be factors. And those are the only possible linear factors. And remember, x minus 1 is equivalent to x plus 1 mod 2. X and x plus 1 are the only possible linear factors, and they're not, because these are not zeros. Okay, so this verifies that f bar of x has no linear factors. It also would verify that it has no cubic factors, because if it's got no linear factors, it's not going to have a cubic factor, because a linear factor times a cubic is what you would need to get a fourth degree. So the only question left is whether it's got any quadratic factors or not. Does f bar of x have any quadratic factors? And that's just a matter of testing. And there's a very limited number of quadratic factors to test. The possibilities are mod 2, we're thinking in z2x here, x squared plus x squared plus 1, and x squared plus x plus 1. Those are the only possibilities, because those are the only quadratics in z2x. There's only four of them. Right? Z2x has infinitely many elements, but for each given degree, like degree two, there's only finitely many. But we can quickly rule out this one, and this one. Why? Because they have roots in Z2. Zeros. Zero squared is zero there. Zero is the root of that one. Zero is the root of that one, as is one. Mod two. And one is the root of this one. So the only possibility left to check is x squared plus x plus one. Is that a factor of x to the fourth plus x plus one? You could do this with long division or actually just multiplication. You could try multiplying this thing by itself and seeing if you get this thing. Let's try it both ways. Kind of weird, but we're about to do long division mod two with polynomials. Do it in the ordinary way, except do everything mod two with the coefficients. What do I have to multiply x squared by to get x to the fourth? Got to multiply it by x squared. Go ahead and do that multiplication and put the answer down here. X squared times x squared is x to the fourth. X squared times x is x cubed. And x squared times one is x squared. Subtract. The x to the fourth cancel. There's no x cubed term up here. We're subtracting x cubed there, but then we're modding by two. Negative x cubed is the same as positive x cubed mod two. Same kind of thing happens with the x squared term. And we also bring the x and the one down. What do I multiply x squared by to get x cubed? I multiply it by x. So that's the next term in the quotient. And if I do the multiplication, x times x squared is x cubed, times x is x squared, times one is x. Subtract, everything cancels except the one. And that's now a lower degree than what I'm dividing by. That's the remainder. And it's a non-zero remainder. That's the remainder. It's a non-zero remainder. So x squared plus x plus one is not a factor of our original polynomial. Again, because it's the only possibility, I could also consider multiplying it times itself, squaring it, and seeing that I don't get my original polynomial. Oh, product of two trinomials. Oh, it's not that bad. Take x squared here and multiply times each term. Then go to the x term and multiply times each term and put the answer underneath. Then go to the one and multiply times each term and put the answer underneath. What does all that equal? Combine like terms and mod the coefficients by two. Coefficient of x cubed gets modded by two, it becomes a zero. Coefficient of x squared, notice it's 3x squared. Mod that by two, you get a one. Coefficient of x is two, mod by two, you get zero. And one is as it is, and this is not equal to f bar of x, because f bar of x was x to the fourth plus x plus one. So a couple ways of verifying that this is not a possibility either. So our original polynomial f bar of x in Z2 of x has no linear factors, it has no cubic factors, it has no quadratic factors. Those are the only possibilities to think about. It is therefore irreducible over Z2, and therefore by the mod P irreducibility test with P equal to two, the original polynomial is irreducible over the rationals. Have I put problems this long in test before? I actually have. But now you see how you can do it quickly. And I'm not looking for proofs, I'm looking for calculations and things like I've written here. And you know, you should briefly say, oh, there's no linear factors or cubic factors. No linear or cubic factors here. And then down here, you'd want to also say it's got no quadratic factors.